Is my screen visible? And I'll just put a thumbs up if the screen is properly visible to you all. Yeah, thank you so much. So welcome to your first English lesson with me. And before we get into understanding what are we going to be studying today, there are certain norms that we would like to follow with each other. Okay. So if you call, can you know, like for maybe chat, put in the chat box as to what you understand with the norms, or if you want to come off mute, you all can. So can one of you, any one of you, just, you know, understand what is the first norm asking us to do in the classroom? Okay, so let's move further and just get the norms clear for today. Okay, the first thing that we'll be doing in all our classrooms is participate. And to answer, if you want to come off mute, please raise your hands. And even if you want to, and if you're not, if not comfortable raising your hands and coming off mute, you all can definitely type it in the chat box. Okay, so the next is keep yourself on the mute. Okay, if possible, please on your videos. That would be amazing. If not, it's absolutely fine. And the last one, please keep your notebooks and pen ready so that it's easier for you to note down certain things. Okay, so to start us to, yeah, excellent. Karina Jaiswal. So let's start off with something. Okay, can one of y'all just, you know, come off mute and read what's written on the picture over here?
Yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That is why it's called the present.
Yes, Rahul, thank you. Now, can anyone tell me what is the context that we are talking about in this particular picture? Like, there are words like yesterday, tomorrow, today. Can anyone just, you know, like, guess out the point that we'll be talking today? Yes, Rahul, please go ahead.
It means yesterday is history and tomorrow is a mystery. And but if today is a gift, that is why this is called present. Matlab, जैसे yesterday history रहेगा, मतलब past रहेगा, और today एक mystery है, मतलब रहस्य है, और आज एक gift है, इसके लिए आज present है.
Very good, Rahul. So what Rahul has explained us is all about the timings. He included the past. He said that today is a mystery. That means we really do not know what is... Sorry, I'm so sorry. Tomorrow is a mystery. We don't know what is going to happen to us tomorrow or what we might experience tomorrow. And that's the reason we cannot plan what is going to happen tomorrow. But today is everything we have. And that's the reason today is a gift. So utilize your gift to the fullest. So that is what we're going to be learning today. So when we're talking about time, can you all guess what concept in English represents time?
Tense.
Very good. I really do not know who said this, but excellent. So that is what we're going to be learning today about tenses. Okay. So without further ado, let's move into it. So the objectives for today's session that we'll be having are, the objective for today is, today's sessions are, first that we'll be understanding. Yes, Ankit, you raised your hand. Do you have any question?
Can I read?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Objective: we will be able to understand to use the tense of the denote the time of action.
Yes. So the first point that Ankit read for us is that we'll be understanding how tense denote time. So how, looking at the sentence, you can realize whether it's in past tense, present tense, or future tense. Ankit, can you read the second one for us?
To develop the skill of changing the tense.
Yeah. So what we're going to be doing after understanding what is exactly, you know, tense of that particular sentence is, we'll be able to even change it into some tense. So if it's a past tense, if I wish to change it into present tense, how can we change it? So there are certain formulas that you apply or form that you apply. So we'll be learning about those. So these are the two main objectives for us today. Understanding how to recognize which tense that particular sentence is. And the second one is how to change the sentence using a different tense. Okay. So moving forward. Okay. So meaning and types. Would anybody like to volunteer for the read? Yes, Rahul. Please go ahead.
Tenses is derived from the Latin word tempus, which means time. Tenses is a verb based method used to indicate times continuing completeness.
Yeah, very good, Rahul. Thank you so much for that. Now, first things first, what you all really need to write in your notebook is the very first thing is the heading, that is tenses. And in the meanings, you're going to write the second point. So the first point is, where did the word tenses derive? So it's a Latin word called as tempus. Derive means where did it originate from? Where was the word picked out from? Okay. So tempus, and the meaning is time, as we all just, you know, discussed. You all need to write in your notebook is, or in your books, is the actual meaning of tenses. So tenses is a verb based method. Now, what is a verb? It's an action. Okay. So if I'll give you exactly like 1 minute, please write down the second point, which is the tenses is a verb based method used to indicate time, continuation, completeness of an action. Please quickly write it down and give me a thumbs up that you all have written it. If you all are done, please let me know. Okay, I've got one thumbs up. Others? Please let me know that you all are done with the writing of the second point. Yeah. Okay. So let's just move further about this. So the next part we're going to be studying, just remember, verb based means something that proves an action in the sentence that we'll be looking further. Now, the next heading that you're going to give in the notebook is types of tenses. Okay, so there are three main types of tenses. Okay, but today we'll be dividing and learning the tenses. What are the three main types? Can anyone just, you know, like put it on the chat box or come off mute and share with the rest of the class the basic three?
Past tense, future tense.
Yes, and
present tense.
Very good. So yes, Anitya, past, present, and future. So these are the three. Very good, Khadija, as well. Chan, right, perfectly answered. So as you all have been answering, the first tense is present, past, and future. So these are the main three tenses, and then they are divided further. So what we're going to be today, what we are going to do today is only concentrate on present tense. Okay. So because even in the picture it was said that present is a gift. So let's just, you know, like deep dive into this topic today and learn how to recognize how the present tense in a given sentence can be changed and how to recognize the different types of present tense that come into the sentences that are presented to you. Okay. So there are major four types of present tenses. Okay. So we'll start directly with the first one without, and we'll slowly and steadily we'll start moving. And please make sure you need to write all this down. So I'll be keeping this screen every time for the formulas. Directions for writing the formulas. Every single time there is a formula coming up in the front of how to recognize or form that particular sentence will be given. So you need to write it down. So for very first thing we're going to be studying is about simple present tense. So now you're going to be giving the heading present tense types one, simple present tense. Okay. And this is the formula. So subject plus verb in the present plus rest of the sentence. So that is how you recognize in a given statement whether it is a simple present tense. Now, what is a simple present tense? There are no other suffixes that has been used in that particular sentence, that ing or ed forms are used. What is verb in present? Simple. I am walking. I go to walk. That's it. So in this sentence, walk over here is a verb form that I'm having an action. I'm walking. So it's a verb form, but there are no additions to it. So it's simple tense. Simple present tense. I go to walk. And subject is the person or the I, we, they. These are the words that are being used. The rest of the sentence follows. So I'll give you exactly 5 minutes. Write down this particular formula. Maybe, you know, highlight it. And just let me know it's done. Give me a thumbs up. Yes, no. Rest, I've got thumbs up only from Rahul. Okay, Karthik. These formulas will help you to recognize a given statement, whether it's in simple, present tense, or the others. Okay, so let us quickly have a look at the examples over here. So the first example states he plus wants plus a letter. Okay, thank you, Ankit. So he over here is the subject. They're representing the person. Okay, then verb over here, the action word is wants. So we represents verb in this particular statement and the rest of the sentence follows. So over here, every time you write a simple sentence, the verb is not being changed. It's in the original form. Okay. Now remember, if I say the verb is in original form, it is represented in the English literature, calling it as verb root. Okay. So every time you listen or read in a sentence, or a statement where verb root is being represented, it simply means the original action word. There are no additions in the word. There are no, there is no change in the spelling. Okay. So the word remains original, and that's the reason it is called as root verb, R-O-O-T, root verb. Okay. So every time you don't need to write plus while you're recognizing the statement, this is just for you to identify. Okay, so there is a second statement like we study every day. Can you all just, you know, like maybe type what is the subject in this particular statement? We study every day.
We.
Very good. So the subject in this particular statement is we. Excellent. Very good. All the replies are correct. Now, what is the verb over here?
Study.
Study.
Very good. Excellent. So study becomes the verb. Now understand, study is in the original form. And hence it is called as verb root. Just remember this word, because in further you will have to use that particular pronunciation or the particular states. Okay. And every day is the rest of the sentence that just follows. Okay, I hope these two examples were clearer to you all. Just give me a thumbs up. Very good. Yeah. Okay. So let's carry forward with the next part over here. So when is exactly present tense used? There are certain criteria where present tense is used. So how do you recognize which are those criteria? Okay. So let's just go further if anybody wishes to read only the habits part. Yes, Ankit, please go ahead.
Habits. I always drink coffee at work.
Yeah, please go read all the three.
He goes to bed at 11 p.m. They often eat lunch at school.
Very good. Thank you, Ankit. So now, as Ankit read, habits are something that you do every day and you do not need to practice. And that's the reason they're always in present. Okay. So habit is something that I'll be either representing myself or I'll be representing a group. So the first sentence, I always drink coffee at work. So I is an individually representation. So that becomes subject. How about you all just tell me what is the verb over here?
Drink.
Very good. Drink. Excellent to recognize. Drink coffee at work. So it becomes the rest of the sentence. When I go to he is a representation of I'm talking to somebody, of somebody, but that person is individual. And that's the reason we go with the word he goes. S. Okay.
Go.
Very good. Rightly recognized. The verb is goes to bed at 11 p.m. And when I'm talking about more than one people or group, we come often with they. They often have lunch at school. So when you're representing a habit, it will always be in a simple present tense. Just remember that. Whenever I'm representing a habit, it will be in a simple present tense. Okay. Now, let's somebody else would like to go for the future tense.
I.
Okay. I cannot see. How about we give somebody else a try? Yeah, Aman. Aman, I hope I'm pronouncing it correct.
Future timetables
or
schedules.
Yeah.
The train arrives at 3 p.m. We fly to Paris on Monday. Classes begin next week.
Perfect. So when I'm giving any kind of future timetables or schedules, which I know are definite, what is the meaning of definite? That it is going to happen. So I can give them present tense. The train arrives at 3 p.m. So if I'm asking, I'm having a communication with somebody and I was being asked, what time does the train arrive? I can give them the present tense. The train arrives at 3 p.m. Okay. Accordingly, we fly to Paris on Monday. So what is happening over here is I'm actually telling somebody that we will be flying. But right now, when I'm communicating with you, I'm telling it to you right now. That's the reason it becomes present tense. And that's why I'll be saying we fly to Paris on Monday. The same thing, class begins next week. So every time you have a timetable and you're communicating with each other, the present tense, simple present tense is being used. How about Muskan going for general facts and truths?
Hi, miss.
Hello.
General facts or truths. The earth is not flat. The sun rises in the east. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius.
Very good, Muskan. So what has Muskan actually given us another title is that when we are stating facts, something that is non-negotiable, which has already been proven. So that stays in the present tense. So earth is not flat. It's already been proven and the proofs have been given to the world explaining why earth is not flat. And that's the reason you cannot change it. And hence it stays in the present tense. Or the sun rises from the east and the water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Anybody would like to volunteer for the last one? I have one hand raised.
I wish.
Yeah, Shraddha, please go ahead. Ankit, definitely the next one.
True in the present.
True in the
True in the
sentence. Yeah.
I live in Washington, D.C.
Washington.
She.
Washington, D.C.
Washington,
no, it's okay.
D.C. She is 60 years old. He works at Microsoft.
Very good. So true in present. So something that is right now true can change tomorrow. But right now, that's the fact. So if I say that I live in Mumbai, that's the truth. So that becomes a present truth. Maybe tomorrow I am shifting to Delhi. Tomorrow I may be going to other country, but that is tomorrow. What is right now? Today I am in Mumbai. Accordingly, she's 60 years old. So if I ask your age, you will say I'm 14 years old, I'm 16 years old, I'm 17 years old. So that keeps on changing. Right now, what is it? And accordingly, he works in Microsoft. Now, what you need to remember while you all are practicing or while you all are recognizing or forming the sentences is this. If you're using an individual person, he, she, or it, an object, one singular object, you're going to be using the root verb. What is the root verb? The original form. And you'll only add S at the end. So if I take the first sentence over in the habits, he goes. In the verb, I've added an S. There's an S being added. So every time you represent a he, she, or it, when you're representing somebody else, and that somebody else is one singular person, you go and add a S to the root word. So first you recognize what is the actual verb and then just add a S to it or ES to it. Okay. Give me a thumbs up if you understood this particular rule. How will you form a sentence if you're representing somebody else? Yes, no. Okay, shut down. The next, there are only two rules while you're forming simple present tense. When you're representing somebody else who's an individual, when you're representing somebody who's a group. So if I'm representing I, we, you, they, you put ES. So these are the two rules that you really need to remember. Okay. Giving you exactly 10 seconds or 15 seconds, go for it. Please write it. Just write he, she, and it. Use S in root verb. He, she, and it use S in root verb. And the second point you're going to write is I, we, you, they use ES in the root verb or verb root. I hope these two parts are clear about the simple present tense. Give me a thumbs up quickly, please. If no, please ask if any questions regarding this particular topic. Shraddha is giving a thumbs up. Just please let me know if you all are understanding this. Let's move ahead and get moving with the second one. It's a present continuous tense. Quickly, please write down the formula. In the present continuous tense, it represents something which started but hasn't finished. It is still an ongoing process and hence it is called as present continuous tense. And how do you recognize if it's present continuous tense? You search the subject plus the word am, is, are, depending on the subject. So if there are plural, there's going to be are. If it's a singular, either it's going to be am or is. Okay. The ing form of the verb. So if I'm writing walk, see ing form of walk is going to be what?
Walking.
Walking. Very good, Shraddha. Walking. Very good. Excellent. So in the sentence, if there is an ing form of the verb, it states continuous. And there has to be a combination of am, is, or are. These three sentences depending on the subject. So let's have a look at the examples. He is writing a letter. So he is the subject. Is the singularity. And that's the reason. Is writing is the verb form of the ing form of the verb. Can one of y'all maybe, you know, type in the chat box or come off mute and share what is the ing form of the verb in the second example?
Playing, fighting,
playing.
Very good. Yes, excellent. Playing is the ing form of the verb. So this particular statement, the baby is playing with the dog, is continuous. The baby hasn't stopped playing. He or the baby is still playing with the dog. And hence it is called as present continuous tense. Now, there are certain parts how to use this particular thing in a positive statement, negative statement. What is a negative statement? Where I'm saying a no or I'm denying something. But it has to be in a continuous form. So what you all can do over here is the positive statement, as we have already seen the example, subject plus am is are plus verb ing form. Okay. Now, what is the only change that you're going to make if it's a negative statement? Just add not. That's it. You just need to add not. The rest of the entire formula remains same. So subject plus am is are followed by not. And then you use the ing form. Okay, and if it's a question, just put a question mark at the end. That is how you do it. The positioning changes. So if I'm asking a question which is continuous in nature, what am I going to do is simple. I'm just going to change the subject and the am is our position. I'll put the am is our first and then I'll put the subject. So if I wish to ask you, are you writing? So I'm asking you the question, are you writing? So over here, writing is the ing form. And as I'm asking you a question, I'm saying, are you writing? So we are using are. Are these three forms of sentences or how to form clear? Okay. So here is the same rule that how you're going to be changing is are. Is an are. Where to use is, where to use are. We already discussed when I'm representing somebody individual who is a singular person, I'll be using is. If I'm using a, I'm representing multiple people, I'll be using are. Okay. Let's carry forward. The next thing is present perfect tense. So what is happening in present perfect tenses? Oh, I'm so sorry, this is a mistake. Past participle. Okay. So the formula is subject plus has, have plus past participle. Now what is present perfect tense? That is, sentence have been completed. Now it has become past, but we are talking about it in present. That is how present perfect tense is being given. So as you say, in present perfect tense, the action or completed or has ended in the terms, it is perfect. The exact time it is completed. And that's the reason the verb will be in the ED form. The past tense form. Past participle means the verb's ED form. Let's look, have a look at the examples. Would somebody like to read it?
I have been in London for 2 weeks.
Yeah. So I have been in London for 2 weeks. So have been over here tells me that for the past 2 weeks, I'm living in London. So maybe it is somebody who's asking me, where have you been? So I am saying them, I have been in London for the past 2 weeks. So it's a complete statement. There is no change happening over here. That is, the action is completed. Okay. Next, somebody.
I have not finished my homework yet.
Yes. So over here, you're not having anything in continuation. You're not saying, I am working on my homework. You're saying, you're informing a teacher or a friend that I have not finished my homework yet. So it's a complete action. There is no continuation to this particular sentence. And hence it is called as present perfect. Remember, the word have is being used in both the sentences because I'm representing one singular person, that is myself. Okay, and the verb root over here was been, and the next is finished. So the actual original word would be finish, and then I have used the past participle of the word, that is ed form of that verb. Okay, and the last statement is, have you lived here all your life? So it's a question that I'm asking you. Yet it is complete, you can answer me. But what I really wanted to ask you is, have you lived here all your life? Can you all recognize the past participle verb in this particular sentence?
Lived.
Very good. Lived. So the actual verb root would be live. Okay. I hope it's clear with you all.
And what is that PASR?
Okay, I'm sorry. I it's my spelling mistake. It is PAST, past participle. It's my mistake. I'm so sorry for that. Past participle. So that's the formula. I made a mistake in the spelling. So it's subject plus has slash have plus past participle. I hope it's clear now. Thumbs up, please, if it's clear. Okay, let's move further to the last to the rules of positive and negative. We have already seen this in the example. Just remember the formula, what to change and what to replace. Okay, so the first thing we have already learned, the simple one, that is subject plus am, has slash have plus past participle of the verb. If you're adding a negative statement, something that I want to say, like I have not been to Delhi. So that is have not, NT not is being used. So it's a negative statement. So when there's a word like not, never, don't, anything like that is being used, it's a negative statement. Then the question, have you been living over here all your life? So it's a question. So what did I do? I changed the subject and have, has, and put the have, has first and changed it to subject later. So I'm just changing the placements. The formula is the same. The placement keeps on changing. So when I'm representing an individual or singular person, I use the word has. When I'm representing plural form, I'm representing have. Okay. The last form in present tense. The last form in present tense is past perfect continuous tense. Now, what is it exactly representing? Is simple. It is complete, but it had begun working somewhere in the past, and it is still in the process of being complete. Okay. So, just give me a thumbs up if I'm giving an example in your understanding. Sometimes we see bridges being constructed in our locality, or maybe you know near the station, or the road being made while we are going out. You see that process, right? You might have seen a process of something being started and it's still in the progress. Yes, thank you, Karthik, for the confirmation. Yes, Anushka. So that is what is that is that particular action is called as perfect continuous. It is going to be complete, but it hasn't yet been completed. It is still in the process. So what is the formula for this? Is simple. You need to add the subject. You need to have has, have, and at the end you need to add been. Been means it is still happening. It's a process which is still taking place, and the ing form of the verb. So you're adding the rules of perfect tense as well as continuous tense. So remember, while you had the continuous tense, you were using the ing form of the verb. So that is how we will end this particular statement. And remember, we have been using have, has for the perfect tense as well as for the continuous tense. So you're combining the two. Something that has started in the past, but is still going on, as we just discussed. So let's quickly take a look at the examples. Would anybody like to go for it? Yes, Rahul, please.
It has been raining all morning since 5 a.m.
Yes. So over here, as we read, it has been raining since it has been raining all morning since 5 a.m. The slash represents either you can write all morning or you can write since 5 a.m. instead of all morning. You can also write it has been raining since 5 a.m. So it is still a present tense because you're talking about today. And it started raining at 5 a.m. It might be 10 a.m. right now. It might be 11 or maybe noon. And it hasn't stopped raining. It is still raining. And that's the reason I'm using the ing form of the verb. Now, what you need to do is in the next statement, just recognize the ing form and whether it is has been or have been. Okay. Next one. I have been waiting to see the doctor for 2 hours, or I have been waiting to see the doctor since 5 p.m. Any of the one. The underlining is already done. Can you all tell me what is the verb? Yeah, have is being used, perfect. Have been is being used, and the waiting, perfect. Waiting. Can you tell me the verb root verb of waiting?
Wait.
Very good. Wait. Next, the last sentence. He has been working on the project since last week. Just identify the root verb or the ing form. Has is being used, perfect.
And root is verb.
Verb, perfect. The root is verb. The same root. When I want a negative statement, I'll be using adding a not to this to the entire formula in the middle after have been. Okay, after has have. Not been. Just remember, adding not is before the word you're using, been. Do not add it after been. And I'm changing the subject and the has been over here in this particular statement. The subject comes later on. First, you'll write have or has. So if the statement has been given, have they been learning English for 2 years? So it's a question. So they started learning English 2 years ago. Are they still learning? Yes, they're still in the process of learning. So again, if I'm using singular person or a singular tense, I use has. And if I'm using multiple, I'll be using a root verb. Okay. Please let me know that all these 4 forms have been clear to you all. Yes, no, please. Okay, 1 thumbs up. Any questions by far for the formulas or any other thing that you do not understand? Okay. So we got a maximum thumbs up. Now I'm let's just quickly take a 2-minute activity over here. What I'm going to do is, I hope you all can see the screen. Thumbs up quickly, please. Yeah, perfect. So what you're going to do is simple. Just read the first statement, okay, by yourself. Let me know what is the mistake in the statement. Can you identify the mistake in the first statement? Since 1947, 15th August has been celebrated every year as Independence Day with great joy and pride.
It will come celebrating, not celebrated.
Very good. I really do not know who said it. Can you please tell me your name? Okay, so the word, yes, Chanda, you also have answered it correct. The word being celebrated is wrong. It is has been celebrating. It will be ing form. So it will be the ing form. How about you all try the second one? Let's take a smaller sentence. Try the third one. Yeah. Yes, that has been made the changes over here, celebrated. Can somebody help with the third one over here? The school staff has been put it flagpole.
Putting.
Very good. Putting. Over here, the word will be putting. Let's go for the fourth one. Yeah, perfect. Putting. Right. You all are giving the correct answer. The sitting arrangements are making on the platform.
Making.
What's the mistake in the making? What the word will be used?
Made.
Perfect. Excellent. The word made will be used. So, yes, excellent. So now what you all have done right now is you all could identify exactly what was the mistake in the statement, and you could change it with the exact right present Yes, no, made. Karina, it's going to be made because it's like it's already ready. So it's going to be made. But yeah, most of you all have answered correct. So what we're going to do now is I'm sharing a form with, I'm sharing a small document of work with Siddharth sir. He will share it with you. All you need to do is complete it today. There are certain questions that you need to do and they're all related. Thank you, Siddharth sir. So they are all related to present tense only. So whatever statements you all have made, whatever rules we have made for today, just you know, refer to those rules and try and solve the statements that are given to you. Okay. And you all can send it on the group by today, end of the day. Okay. Make sure that you all upload the pictures. And what you want to do while you all are solving that particular sheet is simple. Make pointers where you are having an issue, what you couldn't understand in the statement. Okay, there is a passage as well where you need to put in the words, what confused you, what were you easily able to solve. Okay, so three pointers you're going to be putting down while you all are solving that sheet. First, which part in the question you did not understand or you could not recognize. Second, was it which part of the questions were easy for you to solve. Okay, and which tense, present tense, which present tense did you find difficult to recognize? Whether it is present continuous, present perfect, or present perfect continuous. These are the three things that you need to write. I hope it's clear to everybody. Please give me a thumbs up. Okay. So the sheet has been shared with you all. You have the whole day to, you know, like think about the answers and solve it and upload the pictures. Okay. So let's quickly revise about this. The last thing for the day. Okay. So here is a quick recap for you all if you have not written the formulas. So the simple present tense is as simple as you will just add the root verb, the original verb, and the rest of the sentence. Then we have a present continuous. You use the ing form of the verb. So how to recognize in the sentence if there is an ing form. Next, subject. Subject plus past participle. I made a mistake over here again. I'm so sorry for that. It's past participle. And the last, you use the have been form plus ing form. I'm keeping this particular slide for like 5 to 10 seconds. Please, if you all have not written it, quickly write it down. So these are the rules how you recognize in the given statement, whether it is simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, or present perfect continuous tense. And then change accordingly if there is a question being given to you. So that's it for today, students. If there is any question relating to present tense that we have done right now till now, please let me know. If you all are there, if while solving the sheet that has been given to you all, if you all are having questions at that moment, please make a note of it and let us know. I'll be very glad to, you know, like repeat it for you or, you know, like this, revise it for you.